has been teaching us all about the animal kingdom for the past 22 years. Can you believe? Let's welcome Totally Wild's Ranger Stacey to Studio 10. Hello, darling.
Hello.
How are you? We should all snuggle in a bit. We're all sitting quite far apart at the moment.
That's all right, because we've got a surprise coming.
Stacey, you've been doing your show for so long. Is there a favourite memory that you look back on?
It's hard. I get asked that question quite a lot. I think the favourite thing is the travel and going to great places. And back in 1995, I went to Thailand for Totally Wild, and I can't believe what I wore. I thought I was so cool. I bought my elephant pants and this little sequined elephant. The animals. The boa constrictor. That was just amazing. I was trying to...
Is that your favourite?
No, I wouldn't say it's my favourite.
What's your favourite?
My favourite would have to be things... Oh, and, like... I love wombats, and I don't like marmoset monkeys very much because they tried to gouge my eye out. But no, I have so many favourites. I love the native animals, of course, you know, wombats, koalas. I love frogs. But recently I did an amazing story with this premature miniature horse called Dumbledore. And born, you know, so tiny, you know, clung on to life and was hand-raised by this lovely lady, bottle-fed. And, you know, I got to cuddle this little horse, and I think I fell in love with... That was only this year. So, seals and sea lions I love. I get lots of kisses. I get pooed and weed on. And I get the lot.
Now, you've brought in a few friends for us here today.
I've got some great friends at Featherdale Wildlife Park. Mm.
Oh, wow.
So I bought a selection. So I'd like to introduce...
Nothing but five.
And Tim can sit here. This is Sarah, Ranger Sarah, and Tim.
Hi.
And of course, Archer, the beautiful little koala. And this is Jack, the saltwater crocodile.
Mm. Oh, wow.
Of course, we couldn't bring the fully grown crocodile because they grow to be, you know, meters. How big actually does a fully grown? I know you've got one at Featherdale Wildlife Park that's 4.5 meters long.
Yeah, and the largest measured one was 8.63 metres. So
there you go. So obviously we wouldn't bring that into the studio, but look at this adorable little koala. And it is soft. It's like a powder puff.
Yeah,
you can actually put the powder on your face. Or
I tell people they can go home and pat their carpet and relive the experience. Yeah.
No, but absolutely beautiful. And this is a very, very special koala because this is the first koala that's been hand-raised at Featherdale Wildlife Park. And Sarah is the lucky keeper who actually got to do that. So, yeah, so the mum couldn't look after...
That's right. She wasn't giving him enough nutrition and she wasn't letting him in the pouch to sleep. And just like babies, they need sleep to grow. So we made the decision to intervene in his best interest. And it's been a pretty phenomenal experience. He had his first overnight stay in his new enclosure at 1 year old, out and self-sufficient now. So
he's just so adorable, and he's a really great ambassador for the species because obviously, you know, in various parts of Australia, certain populations are having, you know, a terrible time out there in the wild.
They are in dire straits at the moment.
They are.
That's true.
And you can just see that he's just so beautiful. And when he gets to be big, hopefully he'll get to be as big as his dad, who's like
eight and a half kilos.
He'll get a scent gland on his chest and he'll rub his scent gland onto the trees to mark his territory.
That's
so he's a
smelling gum leaves.
Yeah, they smell good.
Great.
And koalas smell good.
If we could just go over to the saltwater croc.
Yeah. What's this guy's name?
Jack.
Jack.
Yeah, it's a good name, isn't it?
Snappy Jack.
Yeah, just on the back, just so you know, he doesn't have his mouth taped, so...
he could actually bite.
Absolutely.
Really? I'm used to working with dangerous creatures.
But, you know... They do, they feel amazing, and the camouflage is, I love the camouflage of many of our native animals, but as you can imagine them in their home, you know, up in the northern parts of Australia, when they're submerged and all that you can see, or you can't even see them half the time, are their eyes and their nostrils just above the water. And obviously they've got great senses, they're beautifully adapted to their environment. So, you know, that's why they've remained as they are for millions of years, you know, really without having to change. And you can see that Tim's got this great grip on, so you're very, very good. It's not going to get loose into the audience.
You know why they say never smile at a crocodile? Because it looks like it is smiling.
Smiling at you, Ida.
Well, Stacey, Stacey, Sarah and Tim, thank you so much for joining us here on Studio 10. And, of course, it's school holidays, so if you want to see these guys and plenty of other critters at the Featherdale Wildlife Park, you can. Or you can see them all totally wild, which is on Monday to Wednesday and Saturday mornings on 11. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.